Hey guys. So the last video I said that if I found another way of doing it, that I would, well, if it was more effective, then I would make another video about it. And I think I've kind of gotten it down enough to where I feel comfortable doing a video on it and just kind of explaining how it's done. And I've actually done some work upgrading some of my melds. So we'll just jump right into it here. So let me buff myself up real quick. Now, what I'm about to do, it does involve quite a bit of a knowledge of pretty much just the principles of crafting and the value of your durability. Actually, just the value of everything that you're able to do, which I'm actually working on a video for that right now, but I figured I would go ahead and try to put this video out. So the hasty touch method will work, and it doesn't require a lot of thinking. This method, if you are an experienced crafter, you'll probably enjoy it quite a bit more, because it's a lot more, you have a lot more leeway on your decisions about what you do. Now, people do muscle memory on the expert recipes, as I've said in my previous video. I prefer using reflect, and if you do it the way I'm about to show you, I find out it works out better. So we'll just start out with reflect. The second step, you pretty much always want to do a manipulation whether you get buffed or not. So let's just do that. So for your first, and I'm glad this came up first, your first centered, you can do a rapid synthesis, which is the way that I do it in the Hasty Touch video. Now I've kind of gone, I've kind of preferred the way of using patient touch. You still have a equal success chance. Like, you don't get just quality, you get three stacks of inner quiet, which is well worth the risk in using it, because you're only going to lose one stack. So we've got a nice bump up to our inner quiet. Alternatively, if you got a good proc, you could just, and often what I'll do is if my inner quiet is still low enough, I will actually just precise touch it up until I get 11 stacks. Which is basically what I usually do. But for this method, you want to, I'm not even really sure what I'm going to call it. I'm thinking about just calling it the condition method. But basically you use your normal steps to regain your durability or buff your other actions. You really use it except for in one particular scenario, which we'll probably run into, and I'll explain when I get there. But yeah, so we're going to just do an observe basically until we get something other than a normal proc. Okay, good. So we've already got manipulation running. It is still very worth it to use waste knot over, you would never use master of men in this situation, but it is very worth it to use waste knot. Now, the problem with waste knot is I have to use actions that decrease my durability to not waste it. So once I use this, I'm pretty much locked into hammering on this craft instead of delaying my durability. So we're going to use it anyway, though, because that's what we're here for. So as I said before, you want to use tricks of the trade on here, because you would waste your waste knot. So we're just going to precise touch it, get our extra durability stacks. Sturdy's fine. You can just do hasty touch. Now this is a normal proc, which I probably would have just observed past it, but that would waste the waste knot. So again, we're going to hasty touch, precise touch. So we're now hit our 11 inner quiet stacks at step 10. And if we weren't still locked in on waste knot, I would actually tricks of the trade right here. But since we're still on waste knot, precise touch. Okay, so now we're going to not waste the waste knot. So we're just going to continue hammering on this craft, even though it's not optimal. If you don't need the inner quiet, I would recommend just using rapid synthesis on your centered procs from now on, because doing a rapid synthesis without the centered proc is, it feels very bad, and you can fail. Like the difference between Hasty Touch and Rhyptosynthesis is only 10%, but you really feel that 10% when you fail Rhyptosynthesis five times in a row like I have before. So I find it's best to use the standard procs to increase your progress and pretty much everything else to increase your quality. So we'll just do that. And normal, we still have the last step of waste knot, so we're going to hammer this out. Now again, now we're free to choose what we want to do. In this case, I probably am going to tricks of the trade just to prevent myself from having to spend anything else on this. I really don't want to use manipulation, but I can't afford to wait around for a plant proc. So again, rapid synthesis. We are going to observe, just try to get past this and let our durability build back up. Rapid synthesis. Observe. Rapid synthesis. Now, even if we didn't get a center proc, we would have hammered it down because we would have wasted the waste knot. Now, I really want to wait around for another plant proc, so I'm just going to observe past here to see what I can get. Okay, good plant. So we can do that. Now, let's see. We really still don't want to do this. We are at 11 stacks of inner quiet, so it's now worth using innovation on normal conditions as well as hasty touch. So we're going to do that. I still use sturdies for hasty. There's no really real reason not to use them. Okay, I could afford to do one more of these. Okay, get another plant. This one's close enough that I'm just going to override the one turn left on manipulation. I'm trying to decide what I want to do. I may end up have to... we'll just hasty touch. We're still high enough on the durability that I'm not really concerned about it right now. And we're thankfully getting RCP back up as we do that. Still need to get more CP, so that's fine. This next turn, even if we don't get anything, I still have to do something here because I don't want to waste the last bit of manipulation. So we're just going to hasty it. Okay. Let's see. If I can use the extra CP and I do get a good proc, I will generally just tricks of the trade just to get past the step, just to help increase the step count. And it looks like I'm going to do a few hasty touches here just to try to draw out that last... rapid synth that I need. And even if you're on low durability, unless you're going to break your craft, you want to take advantage of any procs that you get, which is why I'm letting my durability go down quite a bit before I do that. Okay, now if I let it go too long, I'm not going to be able to actually finish this. Okay, good plant. Unfortunately, there's really nothing I can use it on right now. If I weren't, you know what? Even though I'm low on CP, the only time, you know what? I can't do that. Okay, so what are my options here? You know what? I think at Master's Mint is actually my best option. So we'll do that and hope that we get a good, there we go. That's a little feels bad because we wasted a bit of manipulation, but it's fine. And we just want to make sure that we keep hammering so we don't waste anything else. I'm going to try to draw out another... Okay, is this going to help us in any way? I don't think so. Let's see. Actually, I'm close enough that what I could do is go ahead and do my quality finish. Let me see. How much do I have here? So I need the 24. I'm not going to be able to do that with 18. Can I afford delaying it? I could observe into a Biogritz. Actually, you know what? I do need... I will need 11 for a focus synthesis to finish it. So I may... What I may end up doing is just careful observation until I get a... Hope that I get a good proc. If I don't, it's not at the end of the world, but it's just not going to be max. Okay, what is this do anything for me? Not really. I can afford one observe. Okay, that's kind of feels bad. See, I can't do... I will get another step if I just do a basic synthesis. What's the calculation on that? I know I'm not going to complete it, but if I do two, will I have enough to complete it? Okay, yeah, I will. So to avoid using great strides, I'm just going to do basic synthesis. Okay, that kind of stinks because now if I don't use my great strides, I'm not going to get the finisher that I want. So we'll just do this. Centered, okay. And to finish it. So that's roughly the same. I've actually gone to doing all my crafts this way, and I usually make it in like batches. So yesterday I made like 18 of these. I didn't break any, and I was able to turn all of them in. Half of them I got maximum quality on, and the rest I get between. Anywhere between 5,000 and 6,000 is generally the rest of them. So I'm going to try it one more. I'm going to do this one more time. And if something else comes up that I wasn't able to explain on the first one, I will speak up then. So yeah, so this time the precise touch came first, which is very good. That means the next, the inner quiet that we're going to get from patient touch is going to be 10. So it's going to be several steps higher than last time. We already have manipulation running, so we're going to have to waste not right there. And we're high enough on the inner quiet now that it's not going to be worth using patient touch. I generally don't use it if I get above... 7 inner quiet stacks, which I am now, so we're just gonna go rapid to bump up the stuff on there. Now I've got waste not running with manipulation has only got two more steps on it, but this looks like a good time to use the other option that I wasn't able to on the first craft. If you get a pliant and you have both manipulation and waste not running, it is actually pretty darn good to use preparatory touch over hasty touch because, number one, it's guaranteed. Number two, yeah, you do have 20 durability loss, but from the waste knot, it's going to go down to normal. This is basically two hasty touches without the RNG of missing it. So we're just going to do that. Okay, now let's see if we can get a observe one or two times. See if we can get another plant. You never want to miss a blue. You always want to be doing something on a blue proc. Let our dealer ability build back up. We're still low on the durability, so I'm just going to tricks of the trade just to buy more time to let it continue going up. Now I can actually afford to use innovation. Anytime my durability gets like 40 or 45, I start working it back down through innovation if I need to. So this craft looks like it's going much, much better. We're going to observe up back up to 40. This, I feel like my CP is good. I just need to work on my quality more, so I'm just going to precise touch it. Now I have to use manipulation here since I get this free CP. Okay, it's still a sturdy, so I definitely want to use it. Get more CP. More CP. Oh, this is... Oh, that was perfect. Oh. Sometimes the RNG works out for you, and sometimes it doesn't. Wow. I'm just going to use Master's Mend in this case, because we wouldn't be able to use all of the Waste Knot. Now we're just going to strictly Hasty Touches. Yeah, this one's working out much, much easier. I probably won't even have to actually do a quality finish. Yeah, you know what? Let's see if we can actually do this without doing a finish on it. Bam. Now, I just hope I have enough. You know what? Let me check the calculations before I screw this up here real quick. So, let's see. Increases progress by 800. Yeah, that should be fine. Focus. So, see there? We didn't even need a finisher, and we still got it 100%. So, I find that more often than not, the condition method that I use generally works out better than the Hasty Touch method, because simply through the act of extending your step count, you're negating some of the bad risks of the RNG, and you're focusing on the how powerful the conditions are, because both of the centered and the sturdy conditions give you roughly between 6 and about 18 CPs worth of value depending on a couple factors, but that's beyond the scope of this video. I'm actually working on a basically a crafting fundamentals, and there's a little bit of math involved, but it's not too bad. But yeah, that's to do the condition method. You use a lot of observes, and then you basically just take advantage of the conditions that the pretty much every condition except for normals. It's much cheaper both on your durability and your CP to just ignore normals with observe and take advantage of the other ones through your various other actions. So thank you. If you guys enjoyed the video, please feel free to like and subscribe. And I will see you guys later.